This is the Portofino Bay Hotel at Universal Studios Orlando, an elegant setting where the top performers of the NASCAR Busch Series have gathered, trading fire suits and team colors for tuxedos and gowns to be honored for their accomplishments of the 2002 season. Welcome to TNT's coverage of the NASCAR Busch Series Awards Ceremony. People in racing talk about chasing the dream. Every driver, every team starts off their 10-month season with one dream in mind: to win the championship. They'll work countless hours building, tuning, preparing their cars. They'll travel together from coast to coast. They'll face far more frustration and defeat than success. After all, only 1 in 43 wins each weekend. But for the team that battles those tough odds the best, tonight they get to live the dream, the very rare accomplishment of becoming NASCAR champions. Over the next hour, you'll see the top 10 drivers in this year's NASCAR Busch Series season receive their awards, capped by champion Greg Biffle, who'll get his champion's ring and a check better than $500,000 strong. Marty Snyder's with the new champion now, just before the ceremony starts.
Thanks so much, Alan. Backstage with Greg Biffle, the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series champion, before we get started. And this is the big night. This is the night you've waited for all year long. You nervous?
Yeah, a little bit. I'm shaking a little bit now. Yeah, I mean, it's a great night. Excited to be here. I've had a lot of fun, done a lot of fun things down here in Orlando. I'll be excited when the speech part's over. Yeah. The banquet and the food and everything is great, but getting up and giving that speech, could do without that part.
How long have you worked on that speech?
I haven't seen it yet. No, I've worked on it for about a week now. I've been standing on the coffee table in my room rehearsing it, and been on the teleprompter, so I think I'll be okay. The worst part is when you get up there, and it's total silence.
Yeah.
You can hear a pin drop in the back.
Yeah.
That's bad.
Yeah. This night is all about the champion, you, Greg. But you have 80 men and women here that work on your race car. How much does it mean for you to have them here?
It means a great deal for me. You know, it's amazing. You know, everybody wants to get a picture with you. And, I mean, it's like I work with them every day, you know. And it means a lot to them. And it means a lot to me.
All right, Alan, he is the 2002 champ. It is his night. In a moment, we'll see if all that coffee table practice paid off.
What a setting. Good evening. The final act of the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series season. Tonight, we recognize the champions. Boy, what a blast we've had bringing the races to America on TNT. And I just want to start the night off by offering my congratulations to everyone in the room for all of your accomplishments. Thanks for the fun this season. It's been a blast. Now, if you've ever been to one of these NASCAR award ceremonies before, let me borrow a line from the old Monty Python comedy troupe. Now for something completely different. Ladies and gentlemen, our host for the evening is a comedian who's appeared on Late Night with Conan O'Brien. He's been on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. Please welcome the very funny Mr. Tom Cotter.
This is exciting for me. I'm a big NASCAR fan. I've never really been around NASCAR as much as I've had the last week or so. I used to be in the automotive industry, license plates, and then I was paroled. But I don't know much about cars. That I heard one of the drivers today, though, one of the drivers said, "Your car is a reflection of you," which kind of bummed me out, because my car has balding tires, a tiny dipstick, and an unpleasant exhaust problem. But I'll get over that. And you know, every time I do a show like this just happened backstage, it always happens, someone always comes up to me and says, "Hey, break a leg. Screw you. I hope you rupture your spleen, you idiot." And they don't mean anything by it, but we just don't even know what we're saying in our language, do we? Like, "I don't want to beat a dead horse." I don't want you to either. There's more than one way to skin a cat. How many ways do you need, you Nazi? Cats take a lot of abuse in our language, don't they? "Let the cat out of the bag." Yes, let the cat out of the bag. "Sorry, cat got my tongue." "You have issues, buddy." "Looking for a needle in a haystack." "Who's shooting up in the barn?" That's my question. "His eyes were bigger than his stomach." "Well, run for your life, he's an alien." "Who is this bug-eyed anorexic freak?" "She's a party pooper." Ugh. "Keep her away from the dip." Some of these things sound wrong, don't they? "He's on the lam. He needs a girlfriend immediately." Well, enough about me, folks. Let's get going. What do you say? Well, let the games begin. Our 10th place finisher drove to wins at Nashville Super Speedway, California Speedway, and along the way piled up 8 top 5 finishes. He's the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series Ray Bestos Rookie of the Year. Let's meet the driver of the number 10 Nestle's Nest Quick Ford. Here's Scott Riggs. Well, your first Busch Series victory came in Nashville in April, and second in California. California was an emotional celebration for you. Let's take a look, shall we?
Let me tell you, he fits right into that crowd right there, though. That car, he was meant to drive that car and work with that team. He compliments them so much. They're an enthusiastic bunch of guys, and he fits right in.
Well, bravo. Very nice job, man. Congratulations. Very exciting moment for you. You had another exciting moment. You had a baby recently, right?
We did. I have a little boy. He's doing great. Yeah, I appreciate that.
Congratulations.
Absolutely. That's, of all the rookie things I had to do this year, that was probably the biggest rookie stripe that I've ever had, having that little boy around. But any of you out there that know what it's about having children, I'll tell you, that's the best experience that I've ever been able to experience this year and in my entire life.
Good for you, man. All right, listen, it's time to get you paid, my friend. I would like you to chat with my good friends here. This is Brad McKeever with Busch Beer and Brian DeHart with NASCAR. They're going to pay you.
There you go.
Scott, congratulations. On behalf of Busch Beer, we'd like to present you a check for $149,896.
All right, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Appreciate that.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, Brian.
Scott Riggs, ladies and gentlemen, your 10th place finisher.
Thank you.
Moving along to ninth place, this driver racked up 5 top 5 finishes, 11 top 10s, while competing on both the NASCAR Busch Series and NASCAR Winston Cup Series. Driving the number 57 Kingsford Johnsonville Chevrolet, it's Stacy Compton coming at you. I said 57, 59. I apologize.
Well, we caught that, but you know, we wasn't going to say anything since the first half started out so bad for you.
I'll be doing the jokes, Hotshot. Well, you drive. How's that?
See, the thing of it is, Jack Sprague, he's really dreading coming up here. You know, yeah. We've talked about that a lot. So he said, you know, for me to try to get in as much as I could for him on you.
All right.
So keep that in mind when he gets up here.
I shall do that very thing. Okay. You've driven more laps this season than any other driver in this entire room. Now, tell me about your season.
It's been a pretty good year for us. We first half of the year, we started out pretty strong. Middle half of the year, we sort of went into a lull. End of the year, we came out real strong. We were 14th, I think 15th, with 4 or 5 races to go. Got ourselves in the top 10. My first year in Busch, and have certainly enjoyed it. I've enjoyed racing again. It was a good year for us. We're looking forward to next year.
Right now, it's time to get you paid, sir. And to your right, you'll see Brad and Brian to give you some money and a trophy.
Stacy, Busch Beer is proud to present you a check for $165,139.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Pat from my Stacy Compton, ladies and gentlemen.
Congratulations. Nice work, brother.
Now backstage with the Rookie of the Year, Scott Riggs, and you said at the beginning of the year your goal obviously was to win Rookie of the Year, but you won some races along the way and a very successful season for you guys.
It was pretty good for us. All the guys on Nesquik Ford worked awful hard. We had our ups and downs for sure. We had some goals set to win the Rookie of the Year. We wanted to win some races, and we wanted to be somewhere in the top five in points, too. We got two out of three of those, and, had a little bit of breakdown there toward the end of the season, but I think that it's just going to make us stronger for next year. I think we've got some other things planned for next year, and I think that all the learning curve and all the obstacles we were able to overcome this year is just going to make us even better and stronger for next year.
That is Scott Riggs, the 10th place finisher, and we're just getting started here from the beautiful Portofino Hotel here in Orlando. Up next, the always entertaining Kenny Wallace and the rest top 10 finishers in the NASCAR Busch Series season. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Back at Discovery Cove with Kenny Wallace. Now, what have you gotten me into now? That's all I got to say.
Oh, man, I don't know what's going on here.
We've got ourselves into, not a mess, we've had a real good time. These Dolphins, they got real big spoilers on them. A lot of downforce.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they move.
It is. This is really different, that's for sure.
You're going to miss the Busch Series next year?
You know, I'll always miss the Busch Series. Obviously, it's a series that has created a lot of great race car drivers and given everybody the opportunity to go do what they want to do, and that's, go to Winston Cup. But I'm going to miss it, but it doesn't mean I'm going to leave it. You know, I'll always run some races, yeah. I think, till the day I retire.
This year's eighth-place finisher notched his first NASCAR Busch Series win of the year in the New Hampshire Speedway to go along with 15 top 10 finishes. It's his first top 10 Busch Series finish. He tools around the track in the number 25, the U.S. Marine Corps Ford. Let's watch Bobby Hamilton Jr. Now, being involved in racing at an early age, what did you do first in life? Take apart an engine or kiss a girl?
We had to do the girl thing first. We done the girl thing, got them, and figured out they're all the same. So when you go to these race cars and you get on with the move, except my wife. That's why she's my wife. She's the one that's above all of them. So
good save.
Yeah, you like it, didn't you?
You have a little dog named Coco, and Coco showed up with you in Victory Lane in New Hampshire. Let's take a look at that clip, too, can we?
Fred, it's my baby. My Fred Wanky, he is the man. He got this thing dialed in where it's a little bit loose. Team Marines, Ford, Robert Yates, and Doug Yates. God, dog, what a motor. I could waddle through the turns and shoot down the straightaway. All these guys down there.
Now, when you went to the pet store, did you say specifically, I would like a rat in a dog suit? Is that what you said?
You know, Scott was up here talking about his child, and you're going to throw rocks at mine. I mean, that's just, that's my baby.
That's your baby. Brad and Brian would like to give you some money and a trophy. Stand up and get your prize,
buddy.
Oh, yeah,
we'll take this.
Bobby, I think we can help out Coco a little bit here. Busch Beer is proud to present you the eighth place check for over $190,000.
Thank you. Hey, you think I can borrow like 25 or something?
Give it up for Bobby Hamilton Jr., ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Well, moving right along, let's go to number 7. Our 7th place finisher nailed down 13 top 10 finishes on his way to his second consecutive top 10 finish in the championship standings. He drives the number 48 Stacker 2 Chevrolet. It's none other than Kenny Wallace. Now, you led the NASCAR Busch Series in overall laps completed. What do you attribute that to?
I attribute to a great team. My car owner, George Devidar, Rick Gay, my crew chief, they prepared me a good car, and we got lucky along the way. We missed a lot of wrecks this year, so it's hard to do that, but we did it, and we got 7th, so it's pretty good.
Good for you. Now, you're the youngest of 3 racing brothers, right? What was it like growing up around Mike and Rusty?
Oh, Lord. Well, okay, if I can dramatize it, here's the way it was. My mom would say, Rusty, go take the trash out. Rusty would say, Mike, take the trash out. And then Mike would say, Kenny, take the trash out. So I caught all the dirt. I was the one, I got all the hand-me-downs. To this day, I still wear Rusty's shirts that might have a little lint on them. He'll say, here, I wore this for a week. You can have this.
Here to deliver your seventh place check and trophy, Brad McKeever with Busch Beer and Brian DeHart with NASCAR.
Awesome. Kenny, we are pleased to give you a check for over $228,000.
That's a lot of
there
money.
There you go.
Thank you.
Thank
you very much.
That is.
I appreciate
Great
that.
Job.
Thanks.
Kenny Wallace, ladies and gentlemen.
Coming up next, Jamie McMurray. His late-season burst of good fortune included back-to-back victories in the NASCAR Busch Series.
He's out of gas, isn't he?
He's out.
Yep. Here comes McMurray. There's your leader. One lap to go. He's got it. Checkered flag for Jamie McMurray. He steals the win away in the Aaron's 312.
Back here at Discovery Cove with Jamie McMurray, two-time winner this year, 6 in points. What's an aviary, anyway?
Well, I don't know, but I think they're getting ready to show it.
All right, let's go.
Ow, it does kind of hurt.
Oh. You never would have thought this at the beginning of the season, that you'd be in a Winston Cup ride and that you'd be winning Busch races, would you have?
I had more fun in the last 10 races than I have my career of racing, because it seemed like every week we were a contender in the Busch or the Cup car. Maybe not a contender to win every race, but we were a contender in the top 10. And when racing's fun, I mean, there's just no better feeling.
Well, if you're keeping track at home, and I know you are, our next driver finished 6th this year. He had an impressive season with 2 wins, 6 top 5s, and 14 top 10s. Tonight, he makes his first NASCAR Busch Series stage appearance. He whips around the track in the number 27 Williams Travel Center Chevrolet. Take a good look at Jamie McMurray. Congratulations on your big year. Great year for you. You had a Winston Cup win at Charlotte and a couple of Busch Series victories. In fact, let's take a look at your first career Busch Series win at Atlanta.
6th different first-time winner this season. Marty.
The new golden boy of NASCAR. Give me some of your magic, please. Can you just share it a little bit?
I just got so much luck on our side right now. We had really bad pit stops at the beginning.
How has your life changed since then? Are you starting to feel like a celebrity?
No, it's so busy. We started running the Cup Series and the Busch Series. Just not really any time even to think. It's been great, though. I mean, everyone asks me the same question, you know, what you are, and it's been a good busy, though. Just every week getting to run both cars, and it's been great. You know, racing is so much more fun when you're running well, and our last half of the season was about as good as it can get.
I hear you have a neat relationship with your dad. How has he influenced your racing career?
Well, I'm getting to live my dad's dream, I feel like. He grew up racing also and never really had the money to do it. Don't start crying on me here. This is another kind of sad story.
All right.
Just getting to live my dad's dream. But, you know, hopefully he'll get to drive my motorhome next year and get to go to all the races with me. And when I won the Cup race at Charlotte, it was a great feeling, getting to win my first race in like 2 or 3 years. But the best part was looking down in Victory Lane when we were doing the celebration photos and getting to see my dad hold up the number one finger. And I'm just glad he got to be there for that.
Jamie McMurray, get some money, will you? Brad and Brian are there to hand you a check and a trophy.
Jamie, Busch Beer is proud to present you the 6th place check for $279,000.
All right.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good job. Let's hear it for Jamie McMurray, your 6th place finisher in this year's NASCAR Busch Series standings. Well, we're in the far turn and moving on to number 5. This 2001 NASCAR Busch Series champion scored his first Busch Series win in Nashville, Super Speedway, in June and compiled 15 top 10 finishes. He drives the number 24 Net Zero Chevrolet. Look out, it's Jack Sprague. We'll be right back.
another great year for you, Jack. You were in the hunt for the Busch Series Championship most of the year. I'm told that you have rooms full of trophies from the past 13 years. Which one is your favorite?
Which one is my favorite? Well, I'd honestly have to say my wife, Rhonda, and my daughter, Paige, are the best trophies I have. And they certainly go through a lot for me to be able to do this. And on the material trophy part of it, I got a badass guitar from Nashville this year with flames on it. That thing is the coolest trophy I've ever won. So I want to thank Nashville Motor Speedway and Sam Bass and everybody that designed that guitar, because it's bad and Jason Keller wants it so bad he can't stand it, but I got it.
Okay, now, here we go. Let's get you some money. I think you know Brad and Brian are going to give you a check and a trophy.
I tell you what, Jack, after watching that, we definitely want to be your friend with Busch Beer. So we're going to give you a check for $330,000 to prove it. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Jack Sprague, everybody. Let him know.
The top four drivers of the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series are still to come, but when we return, Darius Rucker takes the stage for a special performance.
With his band Hootie and the Blowfish, he sold over 20 million records and won two Grammys. This summer, he released his first solo record, Back to Then, which showcased his R&B roots. Performing his hit, Wild One, please welcome Hidden Beach recording artist, Darius Rucker. For the seventh straight year, this NASCAR Busch Series driver makes a stage appearance. Charging forward with 17 top 10 finishes, you'll find him in the number 18 MBNA Pontiac. Folks, check out Mike McLaughlin. Mike, I gotta know, who came up with your nickname, Magic Shoes?
Magic Shoes. That goes back to dirt racing 1980. An announcer by the name of Joe Murata gave me that nickname. I believe we had lost a couple right rear tires and pitted, come back and ended up winning the race. And that nickname pretty much followed me throughout my racing career.
It stuck.
It definitely stuck.
All right, now your sponsor...
Whether I wanted it or not, it stuck.
It'll follow you forever. Now your sponsor is MBNA. And does your wife get a credit card with this deal somehow?
Yeah, MBNA's been good to us. We have plenty of credit cards. The bad thing is I still have to pay the check and pay the bill at the end of each month. But yeah, MBNA's been a great sponsor and a big part of Joe Gibbs Racing. I've really enjoyed my 2 years there.
You know what? It's time to pay you. We're going to change your nickname from Magic Shoes to Piper, and it's time to pay the Piper. That's Brad and Brian. They're going to give you some money and a check and a trophy.
Well, Mike, I tell you what, Busch Beer wants to help you pay some of those credit card bills, so we got a check for $381,000.
Wow, that's awesome.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
There he goes, folks. Your fourth place finisher in the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series, Mike McLaughlin.
Thank you very much.
Still to come, Scott Wimmer. Last year's Rookie of the Year runner-up, Wimmer got his first Busch Series victory in 2002 and finished the year with four wins. And here comes Scott Wimmer to the caution flag, and what will be
He's coming.
His first NASCAR Busch Series
white
victory.
Flag, baby. He's yours.
Greg Biffle, the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series champion. Stay tuned to TNT later this evening to see the NASCAR Winston Cup Banquet crown their champion and top 10 drivers.
If this were the Olympics, your next driver would be the bronze medalist, driving to four consecutive wins in the season's final eight events, including his first career NASCAR Busch Series victory at Dover. He totaled 17 top 10 and 11 top 5 finishes. He drives the number 23, the Bill Davis Racing Pontiac. This is Scott Wimmer.
Scott, how are you, buddy?
Well, I heard something about you. Tell me if it's true. You started running better this year, really well, in fact, when you started wearing a Dick Trickle t-shirt. What is it about the t-shirt that got you going?
Yeah, Dick Trickle, he's from Wisconsin, real close to my hometown, and my father's good friends with him, and I grew up around Dick Trickle and Tom Reffner and people like that, and one of my good friends gave me the shirt. He said it'll give you good luck, and wore it, and, you know, I finished, I think, in the top 10 almost every time I wore the shirt. So the guys are getting kind of sick of it, and it stands by itself in the corner of the trailer, and nobody touches it, and but it's been a pretty good piece for me.
Because you started kind of slow this year, but then you had a huge turnaround. And what do you attribute that to? Not just the t-shirt, I'm guessing.
My car owner, Bill and Gail Davis, they put a lot of faith into me. And my team manager, Fletcher Lord, he stepped up, and my crew chief and my guys, and we just all stepped up. We were close to shutting that team down, and we didn't want to do that, and we were fortunate enough we were able to keep it together and get some wins at the end of the year, too.
Hey, let's get you some money. Brian and Brad have a check and a trophy for you.
Scott, Busch Beer is proud to present you the third place check of $432,000.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
One more time for Scott Wimmer, third place in this year's NASCAR Busch Series. This year's runner-up posted wins in North Carolina Speedway, Talladega Super Speedway, Richmond International Raceway, and Nazareth Speedway, challenging for the title throughout the season. Tonight marks the fourth consecutive year he's making a NASCAR Busch Series stage appearance. He drives the number 57 Albertsons Ford. It's Jason Keller.
Well, I saw you were up here working real hard, so I figured we'd share a smooth drinking Busch
hero.
Ride. Didn't think you had anything to drink here.
Well, that's very nice of you. I appreciate it. Four wins, two poles. How do you account for such a great season?
Good crew. You know, you've heard all the drivers talk about the crews. Steve Agington and myself have been together for a long time, and Greg Pollux, our owner, he's just... He gives us everything we need to run up front, and driver's only a small piece of it. We get the glory, and I'm looking for the big check anyway, but we get the big checks and the trophies, but it's all about the team and who you're with, and looking forward to next year.
Now, I know you have a couple of kids. You got Joe and Jade. Now, when they act up, do you give them a timeout, or do you just wave the yellow caution flag?
Mostly they put me in timeout before I put them in timeout, and I've got my kids are just... You don't have to be around me very long to know how I feel about my kids. They're just fantastic, and my wife Deborah, and then their support, it means so much. We get to go and do something that we really love to do, and they got the hard job. They have to stay at home. My wife has to stay at home, take care of the kids, and it's a great combination.
Well, you are the man, and it's time to pay the man. Joining us now to present your check and trophy is Brad McKeever with Busch Beer and Brian DeHart with NASCAR.
Jason, Busch does have a big check for you.
All right.
And congratulations on the great season, a second place finish, and here's a second place check for $508,000. Wow. Congratulations. Yeah.
Congratulations.
Jason Keller, winner of the Gatorade Front Runner Award, and second place in the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series.
Still to come, a salute to this year's NASCAR Busch Series champion, Greg Biffle.
An impressive season merits an impressive trophy. I'm sure you have a place in Greenville for that big thing, but when you look back on this season, Jason, what will you remember the most?
Well, we'll definitely remember the wins, but bad thing about our sport, we'll probably remember the ones that got away more than anything. It's been a learning year, and hopefully we can take what this year gave us and learn from it and be stronger. It's the first year we've ever really been in a championship battle, so hopefully that'll make us stronger on down the stretch. Next years to come.
Yeah. I talked to Greg Biffle this morning. He said something amazing to me. He said he wanted you to win at Homestead. What does that say about the race for the championship you guys had? I mean, yeah, you developed a really good friendship.
We really did, and Greg is a tremendous competitor. You know, we talked about it a lot over the last couple of weeks. You know,
competition is what we want. I mean, definitely I wanted to beat him, but, you know, we want good competition, and we had good competition all year long, and I really wanted to be on that front straightaway celebrating with him at Homestead, but fell about half a lap short on fuel, but maybe in years to come we'll race some more.
Well, somebody's got to put up the dough to make the car go. Here to present the NASCAR Busch Series Champion Car Owner Award, please welcome the Executive Vice President for NASCAR, Mr. Brian France.
Good evening. Jack Roush celebrated his first NASCAR championship after winning the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series title in 2000 with Greg Biffle. Greg and crew chief Randy Gross and Jack have again teamed up to win another championship, this time in the NASCAR Busch Series. As we all know, Jack has had quite a year on and off the track, and we hope this championship is extra special. On behalf of NASCAR and the entire sport, I'm extremely proud to present the 2002 Champion Car Owner Award to Jack Roush. Congratulations, Jack.
Good evening. On the subject of NASCAR championships. Since Roush Racing entered NASCAR competition in 1988, we found NASCAR championships to be incredibly prized, hotly contested, and elusive. Elusive, that is, until Greg Biffle joined the team in 1997, courtesy of Benny Parsons and Granger. I've been personally blessed with so many wonderful people who have stepped in to be such an important part of my life and the success I've enjoyed. I don't have enough time tonight to give all the credit and the thanks that are due. However, I cannot accept my portion of this NASCAR Busch Grand National Series Championship without expressing my deepest gratitude for the unbelievable chance I have been given to be here with you tonight. That thanks goes out to my personal hero, retired Sergeant Major Larry Hicks. As all of you in the auditorium are aware, Sergeant Major Hicks has been accompanied by his wife, Donna, and they've joined us here tonight from Troy, Alabama. Sergeant Major Hicks, he now insists that I call him Larry, received training from the U.S. Marine Corps for the emergency rescue of people trapped underwater in small aircraft and helicopters in the 1970s. As many of you know, I had an accident in a small aircraft in Troy last April, and Larry was there for me. Moving on, we've just closed out our fifth season with Granger, and next year we continue together in an effort that we hope will see Greg win the Rookie of the Year title in his third different NASCAR series. And to all of NASCAR's family of fans, and to the print, radio, and TV reporting media, we at Roush Racing can't wait to join you next year as we compete in the greatest spectacle on earth, NASCAR.
Last year, he was saluted as the NASCAR Busch Series Rookie of the Year. This year, he returns to the stage as series champion. Greg Biffle, coming up next. Welcome back to Orlando for the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series Awards Ceremony. Presentations are about to begin for the series champion, Greg Biffle. Here's Tom Cotter.
Congratulations to the entire championship team on a fine 2002 season. Of course, a fast car isn't going anywhere without an ace driver. Your number one driver this year posted 25 top 10 finishes, 20 top fives, and 4 victories, along with more than $1.2 million of prize money. He drives the number 60 Ford Ranger. It's your 2002 NASCAR Busch Series champion, Greg Biffle. Here comes the big payoff to deliver the championship trophy and point fund award. Please welcome the director of Busch Brands for Anheuser-Busch, Mr. Danny Scott.
Greg, you are a true champion. 4 NASCAR Busch Series victories, 20 top 5 finishes, and 25 top 10s. This has truly been an outstanding season. On behalf of Busch Beer, congratulations to you, team owner Jack Roush, crew chief Randy Goss, and the entire number 60 Granger team. And here's a check for you for $1,016,244.
To deliver this evening's final honor, the presentation of the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series Championship ring to Greg Biffle, please welcome NASCAR President Mike Helton.
Greg, we're very proud of the NASCAR Busch Series, and we think that the statistics, the 34 race schedule that goes back and forth across the country, the tens of thousands of folks who watch it in the grandstand, and the millions of people who watch the NASCAR Busch Series on Fox and FX, NBC and TNT, are proof that it's the second best form of motorsports in all this country. We're also proud of Jack Roush and Granger and the effort that they put behind you in your career, albeit short, but very successful. But most importantly, we're very proud to have you as our NASCAR Busch Series champion. We hope you've enjoyed this week. Congratulations to you. And I got a good feeling about seeing you a lot in these situations in the future. Congratulations, Greg.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your NASCAR 2002 Series champion, Greg Biffle.
That's nice. Yeah. That's very nice. I like this new format of the banquet, but I don't like it. I'm the only driver that has to give a speech. I think I'm going to protest that next year. But this is great. This is a second phase of a three-part dream that has come true for me. And hopefully I'll be on stage someday in New York doing this again. Most everyone knows the story about how I got teamed up with Roush Racing, but I like it so much I'd like to tell it again. In 97, a good friend of mine, which many of you know, went to Jack and told him if he didn't put me in one of his race cars, he'd regret it. Jack took those words to heart, but that first year must have been wondering what Benny had against him. Jack, I can't thank you enough for giving me the opportunity to drive for your organization. Jack took a special interest this season in our program about midway through the year. We were having some struggles, had some engine problems, and Jack came in and gave us the technical support and everything it took to get our program back going. We wouldn't be here tonight if it wasn't for his help. You personally have had an interesting year, Jack, and I'm glad that you're with us tonight to celebrate. And I want to thank Larry for that. It's a great honor for me to give you your first NASCAR Busch Series title and second NASCAR championship. And to everyone on the Granger team and all the wives and girlfriends and family members that are here, why don't you all stand up for me? I just want you guys to know that I appreciate all the hard work that you put in each and every week. And I thank you guys for making me look so good. You guys are the 2002 NASCAR Busch Series Championship champions, and don't ever forget it. You've worked hard for this evening, so enjoy it. I'm gonna miss competing in the Busch Series full time with all the other drivers, but I'm looking forward to moving on to Winston Cup. The level of competition and professionalism exerted by everyone in this series has definitely prepared me for my next step in my career. Thanks to all of you. Have a wonderful holiday season, and I'd like to take this opportunity to invite each and every one of you to our party after the ceremony concludes. And those of you that can't come, have family and friends and other commitments, we understand, and we look forward to seeing you in Daytona. Thanks.
Once again, everybody, your 2002 NASCAR Busch Series Championship team.
Been a great evening for Busch Series champion Greg Biffle. Our congratulations go out to Greg, crew chief Randy Goss, owner Jack Roush, and the entire Ford Granger team. But the awards don't stop here in Orlando. Later tonight at 8 Eastern, NASCAR salutes its Winston Cup stars live from New York City. James Woods hosts, along with a performance by Sheryl Crow. Bill Weber and I will be there to bring you all the ceremonies. For Marty Snyder, this is Alan Bestwick. So long from Orlando and the NASCAR Busch Series Awards Ceremony.